Suppose now that you do not have enough money to purchase the furniture and espresso machines and need to borrow $15,000. You contribute the rest, that is $30,000. You promise the bank to pay $5,000 every year to reduce the principal plus an interest rate of 10%. Suppose that immediately after setting up your firm, an investor approaches you to buy your equity in the business. How much should you sell it for? The most natural way to approach this problem is to compute the future cash flow this investor receives by buying the equity of the firm. This problem is different from the previous one because the equity holders no longer receive 100% of the cash flows the firm generates. Instead, the firm first needs to repay the principal and interest on the debt. Equity holders only receive what is left. This table shows you the cash flows the equity holders receive. As in the previous example, the firm generates $80,000 in revenue, pays $30,000 in rent, $25,000 in salary, and $50,000 in coffee bean. In addition, at the end of year one, the firm pays $5,000 to reduce the principal it owes, and it also pays interest on the debt. The interest on the $15,000 debt is 10% of $15,000, or $1,500. The rest, that is $3,500, is what equity holders receive. The situation in year two is similar, except that the interest is lower as the balance on the debt in year two is only $10,000. Recall that you pay $5,000 of the principal at the end of year one. Therefore, the interest is 10% of $10,000 or $1,000. In year two, therefore, equity holders receive $4,000. The situation is again similar for year three. The balance on the debt in year three is $5,000, and hence the interest is only $500. In year three, you finish paying the principal on the debt, and hence from year four on, the firm is debt-free, and there are no more principal or interest payments. From year four on, equity holders get $10,000 per year. Now that we have the cash flows equity holders receive, we can compute the value of equity. We need a discount rate. In the previous example, we used 10% to discount the cash flows. As we will see in course 3, the discount rate we use to discount cash flows to equity holders increases when the firm has debt. Since we have not learned yet how to compute discount rates, I am simply going to use 10%. The main point I will make in this section will still hold when we properly adjust the rate at which the firm can borrow and the discount rate for equity cash flows. The cash flows equity holders receive are $3,500, $4,000, $4,500 in years 1, 2, and 3, and starting in year 4, they are $10,000. Note that starting in year 4, we have a perpetuity. To find the present value of this cash flow stream, we do two separate calculations. One is the present value of the first three cash flows, and the second is the present value of the cash flows that start in year 4. Applying the present value formula to the first three cash flows, we obtain a present value of $9,868.52. To compute the present value of the perpetuity that starts in year 4, we first pretend that we are standing in year 3. From this viewpoint, the perpetuity starts next year, and we can apply the perpetuity formula and obtain a value of $100,000. Recall that this value is as of year 3. Discounting this value 3 years to year 0 leads to a value of $75,131.48. Now, adding the two pieces leads to $85,000. Therefore, the market value of the equity of the firm at year zero is 85,000. We obtain this number by painstakingly computing the cash flows that equity holders receive each period and then discounting these cash flows. The cash flows we computed here are called cash flows to equity, and this approach to equity valuation is called the cash flow to equity method.